Christ is born. Glorify Him. I greet all of you this evening with these first words of St. Gregory the Theologian's Christmas homily, preached over 1600 years ago. 400 years later, this stunning phrase inspired St. Cosmas, the Bishop of Mayumah in Gaza. Bishop who was the adopted brother of St. John of Damascus. They inspired him to write the canon of the Feast of Christmas that we all know, beginning with Christos Gennade Doxaste. We all sing and chant these hymns tonight and tomorrow in order to join with the angels of heaven. Angels who appear on the shepherds in the field and fill the night sky with the hymn Doxa en ipsistis Theo και επί γης ειρήνη εν ανθρώπης ευδοκία. Is it not marvelous that before every divine liturgy, when we close the altars, the doxology that includes the celestial hymn of the angels is chanted? Why? Because every divine liturgy is an opportunity to give birth to Christ the Lord in our lives. He was born in the most humble and poor circumstances of the world at his own nativity, in a cave with beasts, for there was no room at the inn, not much for a king. Who ever heard of a birth of a king without servants, without guards, without attendants? But the Lord was born in the greatest servant of all, the handmaid of the Lord, His Holy Mother, our Panagia. He was born with an old man as His honor guard. But the aged Joseph was the ancestor of kings, King David and King Solomon, and he proved the most worthy guardian ever. And his attendants were the humble shepherds and the lowly animals who bowed in wonder before him. This is how Christ was born in Bethlehem. Of Judea in humbleness and meekness, and this is how He is born within us, so that we may also bring Him forth in the world by our thoughts, by our words, and by our actions. Just as Jesus was born in the most humble of circumstances, we also can bring Him forth in small and modest ways. We do not have to be rich or powerful to manifest God's love in the world. We do not have to set up philanthropies and charities or make supersized donations, even though if we are able to do so, it is a good and praiseworthy work. All we have to do is to think and act with kindness, with warm-heartedness, understanding, respect, humility, mercy, forgiveness, and compassion towards others. All of these qualities are the characteristics of God's love towards us, and they are marks of the sincerity and genuineness of our love for God, when we manifest them for our neighbor. The cave in Bethlehem that the Lord shared with the beasts of the stable is an icon of the human heart. Inside each and every one of us is an untamed element, an instinctual reactivity that often strikes out against against others. When we hurt and when we injure others in thought, in word or deed, it is because we are reacting out of our own pain. Like an animal, we are insensible to the pain of the others, and so we strike out. If it becomes a habit of self-protection, it really is soul-destroying and heart-numbing. But when we welcome the Lord to our innermost selves, through His immeasurable love for us, and in the Holy Sacrament, then He makes His home inside of us. As it says in the Gospel of John, και ο λόγος σάρξ εγένετο και εσκήνωσε εν ημίν. And the Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. And when He makes His home within us, He takes all the savage movements in our minds and in our hearts. Movements that lie just beneath our conscious awareness. We are not afraid of God. Because who is afraid of a newborn baby? He comes ever so gently in our hearts. He does not spurn us if we are poor and destitute of virtue. His goodness nourishes us, just as He suckled at the breast of His Holy Mother, our Panagia. Our strongest advocate with the Lord is the Theotokos, the Panagia, who humbled herself to enter the cave and to give birth to her son. Remember, she was the daughter of rich parents, Joachim and Anna, but she was obedient to God, not out of fear, but out of wisdom and faith. She entered the cave to give birth, and in so doing, she opened the gates of paradise for all of us. This is the profound and awesome mystery that we behold and venerate tonight, my dear brothers and sisters. Illumined by the star of love and peace, surrounded by the simplicity of that night in Bethlehem, a mother's love, a guardian's protection, the shepherd's wonder, the Magi's gifts, we too are called to enter. To enter into the cave of our hearts and discover the most precious gift that God has ever given to the world, incarnate love. May the miracle of the Lord's Holy Nativity fill your hearts and minds with love for Him, the gentle babe of Bethlehem, and may He grant unto us all a blessed feast of Christmas and a safe, prosperous, and healthy New Year. Christos genate doxasa, Christ is born, glorified.